The protesters were carrying placards with inscriptions like EEDC lift ban on transformer installation. We are tired of darkness. Install transformers given to us by our governor, among others. Speaking to newsmen, the leader of the group, Mrs. Promise Ezigwe, lamented that they have been in darkness for over 1 year, a situation which, according to her, has crippled economic activities at the various parts of Awka that are affected. Mrs. Ezigwe explained that Governor Willie Obiano donated transformers to all the affected parts since the past 6 months, but none of them has been installed.
When you dump that transformers a long time, many people will go there removing some valuable something there. The transformers can no longer be useful to us.
Contributing, the secretary of the group, Mrs. Anne Nwakaozo, regretted that they are forced to pay for electricity even when they were not supplied with power, adding that they have contacted EEDC severally for the installation, which has yielded no result. Reacting to the allegation, the communication officer, EEDC Awka office, Mrs. Maureen Onyong, claimed that they were not aware that government donated such transformers, as according to her, government was supposed to give them notice about the transformers and request for installation. In a swift reaction, the Commissioner for Power and Domestic Water Supply, Mr. Obi Nwankwo, expressed shock over the denial by the EEDC, who claimed that they are unaware of the transformers, saying that his ministry had before transporting transformers to the various communities, written to EEDC, aside the various meetings they had with their management. Mr. Nwankwo said government has distributed over 400 transformers to various communities, wondered why the EEDC is showing lackadaisical attitude towards installation of the transformers, even when the state government has helped them to procure the transformers, which is their primary obligation.
The state governor is so kind enough to do the work of EEDC by providing these facilities. These are the obligation of the EEDC. I don't understand why they should be saying that they are not aware of it. They are fully aware of it.
Investigating the issue further, ABS discovered that most communities in Awka capital city like Okpuno, Isuani Ocha, Mbaku, to mention but a few, have been in darkness for the past 2 months. In Awka, I am Ngozi Obileri for ABS News.